In this tutorial in ZOHO Projects, we're going to show you how you can set up your milestones, your task lists, and your tasks. So let's dive in. All right, so we're now in ZOHO Projects here. We have our fake or demo account. As we've been playing around with it, we have the Smith residence we created the last tutorial. So in this tutorial, we're going to show you how you can go about actually creating your task list. We kind of introduced you to this view over here, but there's a lot more to it. So you have all these different tabs up here, right? So your dashboard, your Gantt reports, your documents, your milestones, timesheet, expense, issues, users, and pages. And then you have the ability to organize your tabs, which ones you want to show, which ones you don't. So in this one, we're going to talk about your milestones a little bit. So in this one, we're actually going to create a new milestone. So we are going to click create, and we're going to say roof replacement. That's going to be one milestone. We think that's going to take maybe roughly around a week from start to finish, let's say, you know, or maybe let's say 3 weeks if we have to order materials, things like that. So we're going to say that we're going to start on January 30th, 2023, and we're going to complete it Friday on February 17th. So that's how long we think it's going to take if we can order materials within that time frame, or if general, that's how long it could take. Maybe. So, all right, we have the roof replacement coming in here. We're setting up the start date, the end date. We're going to add that one in there. And then we have the ability to add a task list. But before we do that, though, we also want to maybe add another milestone. We're going to say, let's say, replace windows. Maybe this is an additional service that they're wanting. And this one will really only start after February 17th. So we're going to start that one on the 20th. And, you know, that one could take 4 to 6 weeks, obviously, maybe depending on how long it takes you to get the windows actually in. So we have the 17th, so 20th, 1, 2, and let's just say 4. Argument's sake, we are going to do the end on March 17th, so it's going to take 4 weeks. So I'm just going to click add that one. So we come back to milestones here. We have two windows, or two milestones, a roof replacement and replace windows. So within here, we can actually create different task lists. So for example, let's add a task list to order materials. So now we've set this up so we can order the materials within that. So within the task list, we can then create multiple tasks. So there's multiple layers as you're seeing this. You have your milestone at the top, then you have your task list, and then you have your tasks. So there's three different layers that you can go down into to create the granularity you need in order to have a successful project that's being tracked. So in the order materials, we're going to assign a new task that says, let's say order materials. So order roof materials. So we're going to then come down here. So the task, so we're going to need, we need the project manager to order roof materials from Roof Hub. So this should only take a couple days. You can associate a team to it. You can associate a user to it. Right now, user one is the only user in this account, so I'm going to select that individual. You can assign a certain number of hours if you really truly wanted to. In most cases, you're probably not going to need this. So now we need to set a start date on the task itself. Let's select the 23rd, 2023 as being the start date, and the due date for this task is going to be the 25th. So we're giving our project manager 2 days to order materials. That should be plenty of time. You can set a different priority if you want, and we'll talk about how you can change this and make it a bit more customized to your needs. But this is going to be a high priority task because this needs to be done before some other items can be done. You can set reminders. So if you wanted to, you can set a reminder at 12 a.m. Or p.m. or 5 p.m. or anything like that. So based on the due date, you can set a specific date of the project that you want to remind someone to do something. And then you can set recurrences. So you can set reminders once every two occurrences it's gone through, or you can set that to be anything you need in your business. So I'd go through and double check that and see if it is helpful daily or weekly or monthly or yearly as well. And then the billing type, obviously you're probably not going to need this, but you can set it to be billable or non-billable depending on the tasks at hand. So that is how you create a new task. I'm just going to click add that one here. So we now have a new task, so we're ordering roofing materials. And let's say we want to do another one for the project manager. So we want to order, let's say, bins. So we need waste bins to be able to throw off the shingles. PM to order waste bins for material. So we're also going to want to probably set this one up. We're good there. Select user. We want to select that user one again. Select start date. Maybe we're going to say on the 24th, and the due date for this is on the 25th as well. That is also a high one. So I'm going to add that one in there. And the more we look at these tests, the more we realize these may not actually fit the title of order materials. So we're going to say, we're going to actually change this to project manager tasks. Job prep tasks. So that makes more sense. So this is typically for the project manager to have to go in and set up those tasks. So now if we come back over to milestones, we see the roof replacement has one project manager job prep tasks, and then we're going to, we can put in another task list that's called replace roof. And we're gonna add that one in there. And within this, you can add more tasks. So let's say roof take off, and you can assign your crew to that, your crew leader to that. Remove shingles from roof. And again, you can just go through and add all that in there. Now, once we have completed putting in our tasks, in our milestones and task lists and things like that, one of the really cool things is we can actually review that Gantt chart. Now, this Gantt chart is actually really handy because it shows all the different things that you have within your project. So the Gantt chart is not fully built out for this one, but you can see that the roof replacement here for, and the roof replacement we have set up is going to take from the 30th to the 18th. So all the tasks that I actually created over here were created prior to the project even starting. So I messed up there. So I can set that just by moving these tasks around, I can change the dates. So this task here is how long the project manager task should take. Because when we created that in such a way that it's dependent on where these things move to. So for example, the project manager job prep tasks here, over here, are always gonna be as long as the task. So if I start to overlap these a little bit, so let's say there's that overlap I wanna create, well now our project manager job prep tasks task list is now only 3 days. So we can see that falls within the line of our project here. So from here to here is how long the roof replacement is going to take. And then from here to here is how long the window replacement is going to take. So you continue to push this one out if you want to extend it, or you can link it and have this one be a required task that only happens after this has completed. So this is the basic gist of how Gantt charts work and how these different reports actually work within your project management system. And it's really handy to see, and for a project manager to be able to view all the projects on the go at once. Right now we're just looking at the Smith residence, but we can actually go through and look at all the different milestones and all the different projects at once to see where they're at. So I hope this has been helpful, and this project manager tool can really, really supercharge your project manager and their ability to keep track of all the different deals and projects that are on the go. So that's it for ZOHO Projects on creating milestones, task lists, tasks, and Gantt charts. I really hope that this is helpful for you and your team. Make sure that you are commenting and liking down below. And as always, make sure that you're subscribing to our channel, because we want to put out more of this content to reach users like yourself who are struggling to ensure that they have a great project management system in their roofing contractor business. Anyways, thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.